Hey, so we have a class today that I've been waiting to have for about a year and a half, and just haven't gotten to it for a number of reasons. Just haven't gotten to it, and so we're going to do it today. And it's a perfect follow-up class to the last class with Bassem. And I'm calling it More Than Thanks, and I'll explain later in the class, we'll explain what that means. But what I need to do is walk you through what I mentioned last class about that talk that I did that really captured Bassem's attention and led him to reach out to me. The issue is, it's the starting point, it is a massive global military empire. And sometimes it's used for good, and indisputably sometimes it's used for bad. And we argue about everything in the middle, because nothing, very few things are all good or all bad. So it's all the stuff in the middle that we argue about, and of course, most things are gray. But what's indisputable is this, okay? The second thing, and this is my talk, the second thing is that we are a Christian nation. 3 out of 4 Americans identify as Christians, and technically speaking, we're not, because of the establishment clause of the Constitution, it is unconstitutional for us to use the government, i.e. taxpayer money, to support one religion or another. And while there are people of many different religious backgrounds living in the United States, and so we cannot officially declare us, again, constitutionally speaking, a Christian nation, we are a Christian nation for all intents and purposes. And most people in the United States would make the argument that we are essentially a Christian nation. And Christianity lives in places in the United States where sometimes it's just so obvious we don't even notice it. Okay? So, even Donald Trump, who I'm not sure has ever stepped foot in a church in his entire life, even Donald Trump talks about the Christian story in this great nation. And here he talks about God's love for all of humanity. But never in my lifetime, this is a very important pastor, Franklin Graham, the son of another very important big pastor in the United States. Never in my lifetime have we had a president willing to take such a strong, outspoken stance for the Christian faith. Okay? We're a Christian nation. It's just a given. Most people around, the vast majority of people around the world who look at the United States says, yep, this is a Christian nation. Americans are Christian. The assumption is that Americans follow Christianity. Okay? So, this is a guy that Trump hired as the National Security Council Chief of Staff. Not only are we a Christian nation, but we are a nation that holds a lot of very anti-Muslim views. And those anti-Muslim views have grown over the past 20 and 25 years, certainly since September 11, 2001. And this idea that the majority of Muslims and Islamic authorities promote or at least support jihad and Sharia supremacism, meaning that support the idea that Islam should dominate and take over the world. Okay? The same people who think Christianity should take over the world and the whole world should be Christian are the ones who are making the argument that Muslims think the whole world should be Muslim. When these soldiers show up anywhere in the world, most people in the world are going to look at them and say, ah, Christians. Christian soldiers. And in our military, where we're not supposed to take sides, you can even find, certainly I'm sure soldiers have the Quran and soldiers have all sorts of religious texts, but here's a soldier with a Bible, and the insignia is with the U.S. Army. So now imagine these soldiers go into other lands, as we did in the war with Iraq, for the pretty explicit purpose of controlling the oil. So none of you were conscious or aware at the time, but that was the explicit purpose, not said outright, but later comes out and say, yeah, of course, it's about oil. We wouldn't have gone into Iraq if they didn't have oil. And we know that we go places and we send our military places to control certain countries where we want to control resources and turn away from other things that are happening in other countries where they have no resources that we're interested in controlling. So now, what happens when we send these soldiers over to a place like Iraq? With the stated government purpose fundamentally of controlling oil. We got to protect the oil. Then what do they become? Christian invaders. They're not just invaders. They're not just soldiers that are coming to invade. They're Christian invaders. You see, there's a difference there. And so what happened was I gave this talk called Christian Invaders. And the central thing that I did in this talk was walk people through an idea. And the idea was empathy. And I started by saying, imagine that the Chinese came here because the Chinese wanted to control our coal. And they just felt like they needed the coal because their country ran on coal and they needed that coal in order for them to really grow and prosper. So they came to the United States. They invaded the Chinese invaders for the coal. What would we do? We would rise up against them. We would say, you can't take our coal. This is our coal. And average Americans would start rising up against these Chinese soldiers who were here explicitly for the coal. Am I right? How many of you would rise up, would get your guns, and you'd be like, yeah, I'm on it, man. I've never shot a gun. I don't know which end of a gun to hold, but give me a gun and I'll go fight the Chinese whose troops are all in our streets trying to control and pacify us because essentially they want our coal. So what I did was say, step into the shoes of Americans who are defending their country from these invaders who are here for your resource. Now, go over to Iraq. And just imagine that you're an average, ordinary Iraqi living your life, doing your thing. And here comes this other country on the other side of the world that fundamentally wants to control the oil that is under your land. How are you going to feel about that? We probably, if you use even a modicum of empathy, you can probably say, well, if I were to step into the shoes of the Americans who are rising up against these hypothetical Chinese invaders, then I could step into the shoes of the Iraqis who might be rising up against the Christian invaders.